And now our continuing series on the greatest songs of all time from 1979, Donna Summer. Hot stuff. She was born LaDonna Andre Gaines on Christmas Eve 1948 and grew up in Boston's Mission Hill section. And like many of the day, she grew up in a religious family and found her love for music in the church's gospel choir. After high school, she moved to New York to sing and act in stage productions and soon landed a role in the German production of Hair. She moved to Europe around 68 and spent a year in the German cast, after which she became a part of the Hair Company in Vienna. She joined the Viennese folk opera and later returned to Germany, where she settled in Munich and met and married Helmut Sommer, adopting an anglicized version of his last name. Her first solo recording was 1971's Sally Go Round the Roses. But success wouldn't come until 74, when she met producers and songwriters Giorgio Moroder and Pete Bala, while working on a Three Dog Night record. Her first album was released in Europe only. In 1975, the threesome recorded Love to Love You Baby. It became a massive hit in Europe and drew the attention of Casablanca Records, which put the track out in America. It climbed to number 2 on the singles chart. In 1977, she released the album I Remember Yesterday. Her albums were selling great, bolstered by her popularity in the dance clubs. She took another turn at acting in the 1978 disco-themed comedy Thank God It's Friday, and it brought another hit, Last Dance. It won her a Grammy for the Best Female R&B Vocal. Up next came a double LP, Live and More. Her first number one album. It featured a disco cover of MacArthur Park and became her first number one pop single. And her 1979 double LP, Bad Girls, featured more of her songwriting contributions than ever and went straight to number one, along with her singles Bad Girls and Our Song for Today. It was the first time a female artist was ever to score 3 number one singles in the same calendar year. And Our Song for Today was written by Pete Bala, Harold Faltermeyer, and Keith Forsey, produced by Giorgio Moroder and Pete Bala. The Rolling Stone magazine writes, setting a thumping kick drum pulse against a raunchy guitar solo from Doobie brother Jeff Baxter, they paved the way for subsequent hybrids such as Michael Jackson's Beat It. For her part, the Queen of Disco snarled with an assertiveness rarely heard on her earlier Euro disco hits. Now, up to the release of Bad Girls, she had been mainly associated with the disco songs, but this song showed significant rock influences. It won her the Grammy Award for the Best Female Rock Performance. That was making her not only the first African-American artist to achieve that feat, but also the first woman ever to win a Grammy for Best Rock Vocal Performance. This song spent 21 weeks on the charts, a top spot of number one. Without a doubt, one of the greatest songs of all time, from 1979, Donna Summer.